Good to have each one of you here tonight. Our 2016 commencement for all God's children. Some of you have been here before, some of you, this is your first time here. I want to welcome each and every one of you and thank you for coming tonight. It's a little bit different because our kids have been split up this year. We have a precious lady that's come to be with us, Lindsay Riley, back here. Lindsay, stand up where these people can see you. She has taken our middle school and high school kids and done a phenomenal job, and we are so proud of her. But the little ones behind us will be getting their trophies this evening. I want to thank you for being here tonight, but I want to thank our teachers. We have a wonderful group of teachers. Most of them spend their whole day working. Then they come in here in the afternoon and spend the afternoon with these kids. And I am so grateful for it, and they do it out of love. You just can't imagine what it's like to have all these little ones come, and they're so special. Because it doesn't matter where you see them, the grocery stores or Walmart or wherever, they point and they come running. And you get those little hugs, and it's just so special. But to stand before them, and to be able to tell them about Jesus is what we do. Let's pray and we'll get started. Our Father, we just come into your presence, Lord, through the blood-bought privilege of prayer. What a privilege it is to be able to come, Lord, straight to you in time of need for ourselves, for our friends, our loved ones. But, Lord, we get to come straight to you, Lord, in time of praise and thanksgiving, to thank you, Lord, for the blessings that you've given us each and every day. And that's what we're doing tonight, Lord. We're coming thanking you, Lord, for this year that you've given us. Thank you for each one of these precious little ones that have come to learn about Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you for those, the parents, the grandparents that have taken their time, Lord, to bring them. What a special bunch of people, Lord. We just love them and pray your blessings upon each one of them. Lord, we want to tell you tonight that we love you. Just be with us, Lord, as we present these trophies to these precious little ones. And Lord, we just pray that this has been a year, Lord, that they've learned something, Lord, that when time comes, Lord, that they'll accept you as their Lord and Savior. We love you so much. We thank you, Lord, for all that you do. We thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do for us even before it's been done. These things we ask in your precious and your holy name. Amen.
What an honor it is to stand here each year and be with your children and be with you and to share with you some of the things that we've done here at All God's Children. It's a program that's been instituted probably 20 years. Almost. And, you know, it's one of those things that keeps working. And the kids are just so, we'll think some Wednesday night we'll get here and there's like one or two or three. And you think, okay, there's not going to be many here tonight. And then all of a sudden, I don't know where they come from. But they're here week after week, just like Charles said about our leaders too, and they're here, and we appreciate it. We appreciate all the leadership in Southside. No one program at Southside outshines the other. We build on each of the organizations that are here. We just happen to be the ones to be in this particular program, and we love it. I can be so tired some nights, and I think, I just don't want to make it. But the first hug I get, and the first, Miss Diane, it makes you feel like, okay, what pain, what ache do I have? We're here with all these little boys and girls. All God's Children starts at 3-year-old. And goes to fifth grade now. And I thought with dividing, we probably wouldn't have a lot. But God showed up, and we probably had, I ordered 43 trophies, I think it is, 42, 43. But I would think that we probably had 50-something kids on roll altogether, just in this one particular program. And we even had some that were coming even last week that had never been before, and the week before that. So we just thank God that we get to do this. Some of the things that we encourage at All God's Children is a point system. And in this point system, they each week, they get tallied up. And in a little bit, we'll get to see the winners of some of those that had the most point throughout the year. And so there were seven things: being present, of course, attend church somewhere. Because we have a lot of kids that do not, or not members. Oh, Miss Chloe. Find a seat back there. Being present, attend a church, bring an offering, bring a friend, know a Bible scripture or the lesson answers, pray during assembly or in class, and bring in your Bible. And all of these are important. And one of the things that's so important is the praying aspect. And we take prayer requests before we go into class. We meet in assembly, and we take prayer requests. And these prayer requests can be from anything from my sick dog, my cat that's going to have babies, to some real serious things. And sometimes, I know the kids see a snigger with all the dog tails, don't they? We even had a rabbit that somebody thought had cataracts. And I want y'all to know God worked a miracle there, because the cataracts were gone, right, Matt? Amen. So, you know, you never know what prayer requests we're going to get. And we love this time. And then we all encourage one of our children to say a prayer during assembly. And, of course, sometimes it's so many, and I hate cutting it off, but we got to go to class. And so we get to class. And our little, Charles and I teach K-5 and first grade. So we'll be ready for us to go out, you know, go down and end our program that night and say, don't you want to go play? Yeah. But then I said, well, who's going to lead us in prayer? I will. We spend the next 5 minutes or more in prayer. So that's 5 minutes or more that they take off of their playtime that they're wanting to pray, yeah, they're boys and girls.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. They have a great time. That's not one of ours. He's too big for our group. He has been. But anyway, then the other thing that we encourage is, of course, knowing your scripture and all, but we also take up a collection. We have a basket, and if for some reason that basket's not out there, when these kids start coming in, they come in, where's your basket? Where's the basket? Where's the basket? And I'll have to salute our youth. They were so used to bring an offering that this year, even though they're not in there with All God's Children, our youth will still bring an offering, and I appreciate it. And what we do with that offering, it goes to mission works. And our mission works are, we try to do home missions and foreign mission. And our home mission this time was, we used it to help with the flood victims. We gave money there for state and local and some work. And we also had several different local situations of family needs and some things that were taken care of. And we used those monies for that. And for our foreign mission, we want to give it to two of our members here at Southside that will be going on a mission trip in July. Our youngest missionary will be Davis Stanley. David, and our youth will be Samantha Brooks. Would you come down, Samantha? We have divided our monies, and boys and girls, you see the monies that you give. you're going to help two of our missionaries from our church go to Nicaragua. Davis, would you come forward? And we're waiting on Samantha. Let's see how it's staying right here.
Sneak out of the room and go to the volcano.
I know.
That's what he said.
But he has been praying to take clothes for the children there that don't have it.
And we'll all be anxious to hear what he does, what he gets to see when you come back, won't we? I think Samantha got lost. Come over here, girl. Samantha went in December. And she's one of our homegrown girls, too, that couldn't wait till time to get to go. Okay. So, Samantha, we divided that up equally. So, this will go to help with your cost or whatever you want to do with the monies as you go to, on your mission trip to Nicaragua. Let's give our children a hand and our youth. Okay. Now, before my crowd gets antsy and leaves me, let's start giving out our trophies. First of all of our teachers and leaders that are here, stand. Yes, Jennifer, don't give me that look. Come forward. I want you to meet these people. And we're missing one. Kim Mitchell had a parent teacher meeting for her daughter, Abby. These are our teachers, and they will, I'll let, Pam is with our preschool, Deborah, and Megan are with our fourth and fifth grade. These, it takes three to be in our second and third grade. Y'all, I always get this mixed up. We have K-5 and first grade, and that's it then. So, Pam, would you give them a hand?
It's been a pleasure this year. They were all there, and when this age hugs and kisses you and looks into you and licks you and smothers that all over you, it's really a great thing. I mean, I've been with this group for years and years and years, and I really, really love this group. And people say, what can a 3 or 4 year old, and sometimes we sneak a 2 year old in there, what can they do? Well, that's the seed we're trying to plant. And that is what we're doing with this group right here, and it's just a wonderful group, and I love the children. So tonight, here we go.
Millie,
1 year. 1 year for Millie. 1 year for Liv Anderson. 1 year. Okay. Just so you know, when we start with the 1 year, each of these bases here represent an inch and grow from that. As you'll see as you go along here, 1 year represents the first year, then we get 2 inches for the second year, and we keep going up from there. Okay, this is Drayton Cook. And Drayton's been our fierce man. And everything. He's with us all the time, making us all smile and stay on our toes, aren't you, Drake? Nice, right. All right. 1 year, Maddie Beth Litz. Miss Maddie Beth is another joy. They're all joys to us every time, but she's smiling. Look at that smile on her face. Our next one is Charlotte Smith. Thank you, Charlotte. You've always been so kind to everybody in the classroom. The next one is Abel Giles. Yay! Abel, this is his second year. Most of them's 1 year, but Abel's been here 2 years now. And then we have another 2 year, and that's Kenzie Sheeler. Miss Kenzie? And Kenzie's one that likes to advance and get ahead of us and learn how to write names and help everybody in the classroom. So our third place tonight is Miss Kenzie Sheeler. Our second place tonight is Miss Millie Abel. Congratulations, Millie. And our first place tonight is Mr. Abel Giles. Congratulations, Abel. And that concludes our part.
All right, this was our K-5 in first grade, and I'm going to tell you, I feel like every year it's our best year, but this really was our best year. I've only been doing it for umpteen years, but this was my best year. These little boys and girls have just been precious, and, okay, there you go. Can you see? Okay, Matt, okay, oh yeah, they're so good and kind, I love it. All right, boys and girls, can we tell everybody what our favorite memory verse was? Do you remember what's written on the board? And it's written on a white board, and it's written in red, and it's written inside what? That's right. So, what is the heart of our Bible message? We're going to go 1, 2, 3, and we're going to say it slowly together, okay? 2, 3.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16.
Aren't they the cutest thing? Does anybody want to tell what their favorite story was that we talked about this time?
Washing feet.
The washing of the feet. We talked about that this time. I don't think that's one that's discussed a lot, but we did the story about Jesus becoming the servant, washing the feet, and we really did some discussion on dirty feet. We won't tell all that, will we? But that seems to be the story that stuck out the most with them this time. And anyway, that's what we're doing. We're hoping that whatever we're teaching, they're going to remember forever. Okay, Mr. Charles, I'll call out the name, and you can give it to them, or if you tell me who it is.
Peyton Ashley. Hunter Morris. This is Caitlin Crocker, but I don't think she's here tonight. Okay. Miss Emily Smith. Miss Kylan Sheeler. Okay. Miss Dana Burton. Mr. Bryson Etheridge. This is his third year. Mr. Mac McCaslin. This is his third year. Mr. Davis Stanley. This is his third year. Mr. Drake Cutter, 4 years. Mr. Grayson Davis, 4 years. Mr. Tyler Kinzer, 4 years. And Ms. Lauren Dean, 5 years.
All right, now I'm going to give our awards for our, y'all be still, back up a little bit. Okay, third place. Grayson Davis. Second place, Mac McCaslin. And our first place winner is Tyler Ty Kinzer. All right, give our group a hand. All right, thank you. Y'all can come back to the speaker.
Come on, Jennifer. Yes, I do. Nope. Do we have enough room to run? Do we As y'all can see, this is every Wednesday. I'm gonna get this list out. Yes, I have a speech. First thing off, this was my first year doing this, and when I was first asked to do this, Megan was teaching the fourth and fifth grade, and I was asked to be a floater, kind of going between the classes. And somehow, yes, I got stuck with all these great children. They really are. They really are great. Like Ms. Shannon said, on our roll, we've had up to 26 in this class. So we're going to honor the ones for the 10 plus and then go with our awards. So for 1 year, we do have Alexis Copeland, who is not with us tonight. For 1 year, we have Kate Smith. One year, Jamie Todd. 1 year, Kimber Crocker, who is also not with us this evening. For 2 years, Spencer Sheeler. 3 years, Brittany Gordon. 3 years, Caleb Etheridge. 4 years, Caleb Gordon. Also 4 years, Claire Davis. 6 years, Addison Buford. 6 years, Cooper Dean. 7 years, probably the headache of the class, Josh Ferguson. 8 years, Keller Wilson. 8 years, Nathan Jackson. So, for the first time tonight, we do have a tie, and we have a tie for third place. And the way this is graded is how many points they got. Like Miss Diane stated earlier, was you know, when you come to church and bring your Bible and all that good stuff. So, third place, we have Spencer Sheeler and Josh Ferguson. And second place with 91 points, we have Caleb Gordon. And first place with 92 points, we have Keller Wilson.
Would the fourth and fifth graders please come down front? Just as you notice that the trophies get taller, so do the kids. And this is the fourth and fifth graders, and we're going to be losing almost two-thirds of our group going up next year. So we only have like two or three that will be staying next year. But this class has been really interesting. They have so much energy. I mean, way more energy than I have. And we certainly appreciate all that energy, but they have taught this year. And every lesson, with the exception of one, was student-led. And so these are your future Sunday school teachers. These are your future preachers. Preacher, if you just hold on just for a few more years, we might could replace you. But we've got several deacons that are going to be in here. We've got several Sunday school teachers, and we're really proud of this group. They're a very smart, smart group. And couldn't have done it this year without Megan McGahan, who has been just such an asset in our classroom to be able to help these kids and to lead these kids in a good Christian way. And so we certainly appreciate her. We'll go ahead and get started with our trophies. Jacob Trainer has 3 years. Congratulations, Jake. Chloe Powell has 3 years. Congratulations, Chloe. Alex Cutter has 4 years. Michael Gordon has 4 years. Aubrey Dean has 6 years. I can read the names, but I'm struggling on these numbers. Sarah Nell Abel has 6 years. 8 years, excuse me. Jacob Ferguson has 8 years. J.C. Wilson has 8 years. And Ashley Bond has 15 years. Our our third place winner, and these kids, it was very, very close in a lot of ways, but our third place winner was Jake Trainer. Our second place winner was J.C. Wilson. And our first place winner was Ashley Bond. We certainly appreciate your sharing your children with us for this year, and they have been a joy and a delight. They have been a handful, but a joy and a delight. Thank you.
Aren't they a great group? And it's been such a wonderful year again. We will thank you, Ms. Brenda. We will start back up in September. Miss Brenda's telling y'all all to give up and give these kids a standing ovation over here. She is our standing ovation lady. Okay. I have asked Lindsay to come in, and she is going to tell a little bit about the youth or whatever. I just want to introduce her to those of you that have not met her. While we're meeting in the classrooms over the Family Life Center, the social hall, Lindsay has the youth in the social hall. And then before we have our classes, we have them all out on the gym. And after classes, we have them all out on the gym. So it's quite a time of mingling, isn't it? So,
thank you, Miss Diane. I would just like to introduce myself again. I'm Lindsay Riley. I'm the student minister here at Southside. So I'm the children's minister as well as the youth minister. First of all, I would just like to say a huge thank you to Mr. Charles and Miss Diane for all that they have done this year. I could not have done my job properly without their help and their ministry. So if y'all would just give them a round of applause, please. I would also like to thank the volunteers, as they have said already. Again, I know that ministry could not be as well as it is. I mean, look at all these children up here. It couldn't function without their help. So thank you all so very much. Just a few things. As Miss Diane said, the youth, we do meet on Wednesday nights, and we have had a huge increase in numbers. Those guys have been very dedicated. They've been bringing their friends and everything like that, and so it has warmed my heart and touched my heart just to see their dedication, even though they don't get a trophy anymore. Sorry, guys. I love you.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure.
But I'm super excited about getting a few from All God's Children next year. I know that the foundation has been laid for them very well in All God's Children. Hey, guys, if you can hear me, clap once. If you can hear me, clap twice. Okay, thank you, guys. Let's be quiet for just a second. I just want to tell you about a few things coming up this summer. We will continue to have children meeting on Sundays and Wednesday nights. I'm excited that the youth are going to be actually leading them on Sunday nights as I oversee, as they step up into a position of leadership. And then we will also have something for them on Wednesday nights as I teach the youth. And just one other thing I wanted to tell you about is our VBS. That will be June 18th through the 23rd. The kickoff will be on that Saturday, the 18th, and it'll run from Sunday to Thursday. And that will be nursery through fifth grade. So if you want to bring your kids to that, that would be great. It's going to be a great time, and I'm really excited about that as well. So thank you guys so much. And thank you, parents, for just bringing your kids on a regular basis. That just shows that you want these wonderful biblical principles implanted into their lives. And so that's a great testament to you as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Lindsay. We've got lots of good things going on here at Southside. Any of our leaders need to say anything? Deborah was talking about they got taller. They all get taller than me. It's been a big thing. JC is so proud, aren't you, JC? Yeah. That was her life's goal there for a while, was to get taller than Miss Diane. By fourth grade, she had made it. So I told her everybody needs to be taller than me. But, you know, It doesn't matter how tall we are. It's what God does in our lives and how he shines through. I've asked our pastor to come and lead us in a closing prayer tonight. And thank you again for bringing your children and trusting us with your children. When we were in Rwanda, they asked Charles, well, it was kind of like nobody else wanted to speak, so they asked him to get up and say something. And he gets up, and we foster a lot of children in Rwanda, the boy does. So he gets up, and through an interpreter, though, you know, you have to stop at certain points so the interpreter can tell what you're doing. And sometimes you don't stop at a good point. Mr. Charles was up there, and he said, we're just so glad to be here, and we're just so glad to see all these beautiful children, and we're just so glad that we've come here to take your children. And he stopped, and it was like, oh, my. And then he had to rush on and say, and help with them here, you know, in your country. But it was just that little pause. But we're so glad that we can be a part of your children's lives. Preacher Jonathan.
All right, let's pray together. Father in heaven, we just thank you so much for this night that you've given us to come here and celebrate the hard work that these young men and women have put into learning your word. Lord, we thank you so much for the parents and grandparents who have brought them here and entrusted them in our care as here at Southside Baptist Church. Lord, I thank you for the volunteers and the teachers, God, who have taken their time and talents, God, to pour into their life, Lord. And we're so thankful for that, Father, as we, that's what we're here for, to teach and to go out and disciple those. And Father, we thank you for that opportunity. Lord, we pray for the youth and children's ministry here at this church, God. We pray for the upcoming things that Lindsay mentioned this summer. We pray that these children will continue to come on Wednesdays and Sunday nights and Sunday mornings as well, and continue to further their relationship with the Lord, Lord. And Father, we pray for those who may be going through a trial or through a storm that are here tonight, God. We know that sometimes we go through things in life that we don't understand and we find extremely difficult, Lord. But the one thing we remember is that we can always fall back on you, Lord. God, that you were there with us in the good times, the bad times, and Father, we thank you so much for that. We love the promise in your word where it reminds us that you'll never leave us or forsake us, Lord. Father, again, we ask you to be with us tonight, Lord. Help us to go out and continue to be the light in this world. Lord, a world that's turning darker and darker every day. God, but we know that as long as you are the light of the world, God, it's a light that nobody can put out, and Father, we're so thankful. Lord, again, guide us and direct us. Be with these children. Help them to go out and be a light in their schools and their families. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.